providing peace of mind, control, and security to data providers, while allowing researchers to find and use the data they need, and creating a thriving ecosystem of developers to build new marketplaces and provide innovative services. Ocean is a decentralized data exchange protocol.
In this video, I'll be covering the super interesting fundamentals behind Ocean Protocol, as well as looking at where the price can be in the short term, midterm, and long term. So if you're already an Ocean Protocol holder, are you considering it as an investment? I highly recommend that you watch this video to the end, because data is the oil of the future. And I think this knowledge is something you don't want to miss. Ocean Protocol births a new data economy. Ocean Protocol is set to bridge the gap between data supply and demand, an open data economy will open the data for scientists so that they can create breakthrough data products, and it can grant data owners a revenue for safely letting the data flow. The Ocean Protocol has two very important types of users. First of all, you've got data publishers. These are people that actually have a lot of data, but they don't really know what to do with it, and they want to earn some money so they can actually monetize their data while retaining a lot of security as well as privacy. All of that goes through the Ocean Protocol. It gets sold on the Ocean Protocol marketplace. And then on that marketplace, then you've got data consumers, basically people that might have, for example, AI models or websites, and they'd like to use the data provided from the data publishers to maybe find out what the market's doing, or maybe do some weather analysis and many other things that you can actually do with data. They buy this data because they believe that the output of their work will be worth a lot more, because they're just interested in that type of data. In a nutshell, Ocean Protocol is basically the foundation on which data markets can be built. Now, if you're a developer, you can fork their code and create your own data market. But the Ocean Protocol does have their own data market. And one other thing is pretty cool is that every data source provided on the marketplace receives its own ERC-20 token. If we look at the marketplace, the Ocean Market, which you can reach by going to market.oceanprotocol.com, you've got many different data sets. At the moment, there's around 287 data sets, and then you can buy different data sets. They can be with a fixed price or a dynamic price. Here you can, for example, get Robinhood stocks with buy, sell, hold percentages. You can get global cryptocurrency market sentiment analysis, deep fakes from the wild. So basically any type of data can actually be sold on the Ocean Market. Ocean Protocol allows users to do a lot of many different things with the protocol. So it's all around data. Basically, users can publish and consume data services. If they've got data, they can actually allow people to buy this data. This data is represented with an ERC-20 token. This ERC-20 token can then be transferred to maybe another owner should the owner change. You can also create some pools, deploy Ocean Data Token on maybe balancer pools to create some liquidity. And you can do a lot more. So you can use the ERC-20 support in Web3.js and Solidity to connect data tokens with crypto wallets and other DeFi services. So the possibilities are endless. What is the Ocean cryptocurrency token, and what purpose does it fill in the Ocean Protocol? Now, Ocean can be used for a lot of things. It's a utility token, meaning it's used in the whole ecosystem, and it can be used for staking. Users can stake Ocean, add liquidity on data, earn transaction fees and staking rewards. That means passive income. It can be used for governance. Users use Ocean in the Ocean DAO. DAO stands for Decentralized Autonomous Organization. That means it's not centralized. The community governs the whole project. The community can also decide which projects to fund. And then last but not least, Ocean is the default unit of exchange to buy and sell data in the Ocean Market. So if someone wants to buy data on the Ocean Marketplace or any other marketplaces that are being powered by the Ocean Protocol, they're going to have to buy Ocean tokens first. The Ocean Protocol smart contracts were deployed on the Ethereum mainnet. That means the Ocean token is also an ERC20 token, but they've got plans on expanding to other blockchains in the future. Cardano might be one of them. Polkadot might be one of them. So it's going to be very interesting to see on which other smart contract blockchains they're going to deploy to. The supply of Ocean tokens is capped at 1.41 billion tokens. 51% of this supply is dispersed slowly over the next few decades, and it's used to fund community projects decided by the Ocean DAO. That means in the long term, Ocean Protocol and Ocean token is actually a deflationary asset. Find Ocean Protocol on CoinGecko or CoinMarketCap by looking for Ocean or Ocean Protocol. Its current rank is 106 on CoinGecko. The market cap is at $657 million. And I consider this a mid-tier market. The price is $1.57 and the circulating supply at the moment is 419 million tokens of the total supply of 613 million. But like we mentioned before, the total capped supply is at 1.41 billion. So definitely a lot higher than the current total supply. You have to keep that in mind. Ocean Protocol is moving into a market with massive potential. Data is the future, if you haven't already realized that. And many CEOs and experts see eye to eye with me on that aspect. Dr. Bellini is one of them, and he says data is the new oil of the 21st century. Like oil, data is valuable, but if unrefined, it cannot really be used. It has to be changed into gas, plastic, chemicals, etc. to create a valuable entity that drives profitable activity. Basically, data on its own, it's not very valuable. And Ocean Protocol is allowing for exactly that. It's opening a completely new market, allowing people to monetize the data streams, allowing people with the prediction models, the AI models, to refine this data and create gems out of it. If you want to learn a lot more about the Ocean Protocol, or you're even considering becoming a data publisher or a data consumer on one of the Ocean Protocol data markets, then I highly recommend that you go over to Ocean Academy to deepen your knowledge. Before we get into the price charts and price predictions, let me know in the comments down below if you're already an Ocean holder or if you're a data publisher, if you're interested in the project. Just let me know what you think about it. This segment is to be consumed with caution. There's definitely a lot of hopium involved in this segment and price predictions. This is definitely not financial advice. If you're an Ocean holder, I think it's good to maybe look at where the price is at the moment. But if you're considering it as a new investment, don't take this video as a recommendation on any form like that. It's just my own opinion on what I think where the price could go. I'm looking at Ocean USDT on Binance on the weekly time frame. There's a very strong support at the blue line, which is at around $1. And this is considered the accumulation range. There's a high risk at the current prices because the Ocean token has experienced a considerable rise in price over the last few months. Here are the realistic price targets for the short term. Now, I do believe it's possible during a corrective altcoin season that we see the lows of $1. It's something that can happen. It's not a certainty. But during the next leg up, a $2 price tag per Ocean is definitely possible. Then we'll see a $2.50 to $3 range during the mid cycle and a $4 range during the top of this altcoin cycle. If the Ocean Protocol manages to launch their project on Cardano, maybe Polkadot in the near future, then I see a $20 price tag not out of the question in the next few years. It really depends on the growth of the data market as a whole, how much demand there is for the data, how many people are publishing these data streams. The more demand there is and the more supply there is for data, the faster demand will grow for Ocean and the higher the price will be. Let's have a look at the Ocean BTC daily chart. And this is really important because you should always compare your altcoins with the performance of BTC. You definitely want your altcoins to outperform BTC. Otherwise, it makes no sense just holding these altcoins. The red shaded area is the Ichimoku cloud. Until recently, Ocean has been in bearish territory compared with BTC, and now it's catching up. The blue sliver is a trend twist indicating a high probability that Ocean will be gaining a lot more in value compared to BTC, outperforming Bitcoin in the near to midterm future. Now, the next resistance for Ocean BTC would be at the 4,000 sat level, which should probably happen in the next 2 to 3 months. That's it for today. If you want another video talking about fundamentals of a coin, leave it in the comments down below and I'll catch you in the next one. Have a good one. Bye-bye.